Yeah, you old pussy ass, cake ass, punk ass, trick ass, suck ass, fuck ass, dick in the boot ass, KY jelly packing ass, nigga, you better get your bitch ass up off the street, nigga. You got 5 seconds to get your hating ass up out here, cause it's a real ass nigga than this motherfucker.
Yeah, nigga, y'all know the motherfucking scope, y'all non-snorters, non-smokers, non-sippers, get the fuck up out of here, bitch.
Nigga, it's a sipping ass, pouring up ass, smoking ass, getting high ass nigga in here, 3-6. UTK, nigga, we putting it down in this motherfucker.
And we ain't playing with you. Y'all know the motherfucking scope, homie.
Now pull it up, nigga.
Embarrassing us. I got the red from Mississippi, thick orange and yellow tusks. Type the coat down on the hands, free foam. The 84 on the blade, 20-inch palm. If you got 16, you can get a visor. I'm chucking on that soldier sweet and sipping on that fisher.
Niggas scared at the floor, some niggas say won't it, won't it. Some niggas say join it, but I be fucked up.
Like Joe Cena, cause you front rap singer, Sandy creaming like a singer. Hang you away from the major, boy, but you get the middle finger. I come danger, rum drinker, occasionally take your bitch to the telly and be a dick and come slanger. When big bun come danger, nigga, ring your alarm. Sexy thing on my arm, cup of drink in my palm. And that crazy shit, I'm tripping on some skinny bitches, something that folds some Florida, the folds some for the most. I'm steady sipping on some sipping.
Let's go. Yeah. foes. Dipping four hoes and I'm packing four hoes. Still dipping on four hoes. Rapping four hoes. Dipping on four hoes. Rapping four hoes. Dipping on four hoes. Rapping four hoes. Dipping four hoes. Now look who creeping, look who crawling, still ballin' in the mix. It's that 6'6 long dick, slim nigga sticking your chick. Pulling tricks, looking slick at all times when I'm flipping. Bar sipping, car dipping, Grant Wood grain gripping. Still tipping on still tipping on spo rolls, spo rolls, spo rolls, spo hoes, and no hackings, and no hoes. Spo blowing on that endo, GameCube, Nintendo, 5% tint, so you can't see up in my window. These niggas don't understand me. Cause I'm balls hog on candy. Top down at Maxis with a big Glock 9 handy. Pieced up, creased up, stand dressed to impress. Big boss belt buckle under my Mitchell and S. Oh, Gucci shades up on my braids when I escalate. When I'm riding spree wheel sliding like a escapade. I got it made, the big boss of the north. Ain't shit changed, I still represent what's your house.
Well, I'm the best there is, plain and simple. I mean, I wake up in the morning, I piss excellent.
Rapping four hoes, dipping on four hoes. Rapping four hoes, dipping four hoes. And I'm packing four hoes. Still dipping on four hoes. Rapping four hoes, dipping on four hoes. Rapping four hoes, dipping on four hoes. Rapping four hoes, dipping four hoes.
Fofos, I'm tipping. Wood grain, I'm gripping. Catch me light switching with the paint dripping. Turn your neck and your dang.
Damn. That shit right there, boy. Woof. Turn the game down a little bit. Impromptu video. I had a video ready to load up. I'm going to do it tomorrow. We got content every day, baby. I promise you content every day. Try it. Except on Sundays, it's the Lord's day. We get back to the Lord. So I got in the brand new City Rhythm. I got the brand new Alexander's. I haven't even put the City Rhythm up. I totally forgot about it. I had the brand new Invictus coming. So all kind of shit. But today we got these two. And I thought, what a better day, since I don't have a ton of orders. I really busted my tail to cut content last night. I was up till 3 a.m. working on content. So I've got about two weeks worth of content recorded and a bunch of new releases and a bunch of Bougie versus Budget, some Central Obsession love, some Alexandria love, some new release love, some niche love. We got a little bit of everything this week. Some shorts I'm throwing in there. Of course, this is Dua week. And 7 days of Dua culminating this weekend with a huge Dua sale only on Duas. We'll have another promo, but Dua specific sample sale at FatboyFragrance.com will be coming out tomorrow night at midnight. I'll go, it'll be more details. So if you want to know, you got to sign up for the mailer or keep up with my post. So Daybreak Chest is supposed to be a clone, I think, of this one. But you know what? Now that I spray this one beside it, I never picked up on Blockade's mango note that good, but I fucking picked up on it now. So I will be doing like a Bougie versus Budget with these two, but I will be doing it in the same vein as I just did a Zor Lime. I'm going to be doing it like kind of like I'm going to do a mini review on this and then a Bougie versus Budget, trying to kill two birds with one stone. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. That'd be a good idea. So that's the plan on that one. So, but it is due a week. I'm wearing this actually tomorrow too. So I left my other one at work, the one I actually wore. Hope nobody ordered a sample of it. And today actually my scent of the day was Supernova Noir. Got a lot of compliments wearing that motherfucker. Damn. Anyways, I keep looking because one of the dog is out and I'm waiting for the white tail to show up at the door so I can let her in. That's what I'm watching for. I'm like, damn it, Cookie. Missy was too big to get into the little hole she made, so Missy was still locked up. But Cookie's running free. She's free! So, it's late at night. She'll be back. She'll be back. They don't... What's so sweet about those... Oh, shit. Boy, I think there was a game. What's it called? Death Jam Vendetta. When you would do the reverse on the guy this song would play, Oh my God, you fuck some people up. This was the South at its pinnacle, baby. That was pinnacle Southern rap right there. Outkast kicked the door open, and these fools took over. Anyways, welcome in. It's glad to see everybody here. All the love you show this channel growing so fast, growing one of the fastest growing channels in Fragcom is Fatboy Fragrance. And it's because we kept it real. We kept it unique. We kept it positive. We don't ride coattails of losers. And we worry about ourselves because I'm a lone wolf, baby. The lone wolf. Don't need nobody. I need you guys. That's it. That's all I need. I need this guy right here, though. One of my wrenches, one of my four horsemen. Spence, what's going on, baby? Gracie Spence here. Gracie Badfinger. How you been, Badfink? Rocking hip-hop, baby. Yes. I'm telling you, the ideas that are in my head that I'm working on for the future. Huh? What'd you say? I thought you said something to me. Anywho, I think T.I. was talking to me, actually. These ideas are going to be amazing. So, Curly Fragrance did comment on my video. She doesn't agree with me about the Spice Bomb vibe. That's fine. You know, that's the vibe I get. So I took a screenshot of so fucking stupid. When I saw this, I was with a customer and I chuckled, and the customer was like, "What's wrong?" I'm like, "You don't want to know." Shit. You don't want to know. I don't think I have it on this phone. Oh, it was so funny. I wonder if I can find it. Let me see if I can find it. Hold on. Let me see if I can find it here. This is a funny shit right here. Oh my God. I laughed so hard. I was like, no, this shit ain't real. This ain't a real fucking video. This. Blow her mind, says Debbie Rowling with Debbie says it's gonna blow your mind. Listen, I let my wife smell it. It didn't blow her mind. I'm just telling you. Ah, the shields are amazing, man. I mean, at least they stick together, right? And give them credit. Give them credit, because eventually they're gonna come out with something and they're gonna want it in return. And that's the ticket right there. See, right? That's the key to the whole kingdom, right? You scratch my back, I scratch your back. I ain't scratching nobody's back. And I don't need nobody to scratch mine. I got a big old thing. I can scratch it myself. What's up, Casanova? What's up, General Giggles? Great to see you guys here. Warm and Frenzo rocking that Dua. You like that Dua Caribbean Mojito, right? That's a good, you like it, the juice. It's a good, eh? You like it, the juice? Slim Thug, baby. He went away too fast. What's up, Spen? Great to see you, man. Smelly Man's here. What's up, Smelly Man? You should have got your package pretty soon. It should have already got you, or should be close. I think I priorityed yours. Send a day Dolce and Gabbana pineapple. Yeah, look at Spence flexing over here. Must be nice. I got a bottle of it too. Send a day for Bad Fingers. Barrett King, King Arthur. Percival. Yeah, Percival. I do. I like Carlisle. I'm not a big fan of Percival. Speaking of being a big fan, there's Bengali. There is Miss Cushy K. Show the love. Oh shit, Cushy K. I swear to God, this does not come on because I went to your name. I promise you. Do with you. This is fine. I do not like this song, to tell you the truth. The squeak in bed doesn't do nothing for me. But I don't like this song. I don't like that song either. Come on now. Yeah. You can play a little bit of this. This is what I can live with. Oh, send it to that white milk, baby. You gotta stay white. Fucking white milk. I never wore it. I just found out I had two bottles of white milk. I'm like, damn, I get two bottles. One was hidden. And I ordered another one thinking I was out, but I still had a half a left. So I added more to the store. Like, hey, we got plenty of white milk. Scent of the day, Florist Elite. Look at Sven getting all creative. Beautiful fragrance. Oh my God, I love RXL's picture. It's a hilarious picture, man. I feel like I still say I look like Robert Baratheon. This is like a Robert Baratheon fat boy. I was on my way to the gym tonight. I've been a couple of days in a row, and there's this fucking right in front of my Lowe's. There's like this road, and it's, and I need new glasses. I know I do. And I'm getting some, not this Saturday, but the third Saturday of the month, I'm getting a pair of glasses. And I've been hitting this pothole the last couple nights, man. There's like three of them on this road, and they're at least this deep. And the third, I was like, I was cussing. I mean, it jolts my phone off the magnet, like bam. And I hit it tonight though. and I started going this way. I said, son of a bitch. The tire went out. Which I had the warranty through Walmart. I think I have to pay them like a $50 copay and they'll put a new tire on there. I'll do that Saturday. So I had to get out the old donut. And when you're in the South, people pull over, man, to help all the time. So, and I know if I get one to help me, there'll be five more trying to tell me how to do it. I can change the tire. It's not that hard. It took me about maybe 20 minutes to do it because I have, you know, the factory one. And you got to crank it up. But it worked. I got it on there and drove home smooth. That donut was a great donut. I mean, shout out to donuts. So I didn't have a chance to go to the gym today. Decided to come home. I'll make up for it and go tomorrow and on my off day. But man, that I got to work out with that damn tire change. I'll tell you that much. What's going on, James M? All from H-Town, baby. Send the day, Sospirio Dolce Moli. It's fire. Yeah, I've heard that. I keep hearing about this house. One day, I'm gonna get it. RXL smell like a lot lizard. $50 hoe. Is it that bad, RXL? I know it's not worth the money, but does it smell that bad? What's going on? I just say Indy. What's up, Indy? Great to see you, man. I ain't even try that. I won't butcher nobody's stage name or they call it their handle. Probably, right? The private keys are probably better, right? God, Juan Berry with my bear. Yeah. I'm just not a big fan of Percival. What's going on, Big E? Great to see you, man. What's up, B Deliberate? Great to see you, too. I don't know what the fuck that means, but okay. I'm being deliberate. You're being deliberate? Who? Send the day, Gerlan. I'm better. Eternal, I've heard of that one. I smell the clone of it, I think. So I got these in. We're going to go over them pretty fast. This won't be a long haul. Did you win those? Then they went to somebody else. Somebody else won them because they were in there. They went to somebody. They went to somebody. And whoever bought them, got them. That's what I do know. Maybe check the box again. Check again. Because I specifically remember wrapping them up. Yeah, it's in there. They're in there. I packed them up. Unless they went to the other guy. There's only two of you guys. It was you and somebody else. Maybe he has it. I doubt it, but I was very careful with packing those. It's way overpriced. It's way overpriced. What's up, Scott? The Rich Martin, baby. Okay, let's get started. Okay, I gotta get this done. This is an impromptu haul. I'm gonna do the Alexandria's first, and I'm gonna save the other one for last. All right, I'm gonna mute myself. This thing's gonna get loud. Hold on. All right, here we go. All right, here we go. I bought Funny Bunny. It's a new one from them. I get this for Easter. I fuck if I know. I saw it and I said, well, let me get it. 100 ml and then 100 ml of a new one. I don't know if it's a clone. It doesn't say in the description. It's called Coke Zero. And it's called Coke Zero. But I'll check over here. Check. Because I don't see Pegasus. I have a rack where I keep all my stock when I'm packing orders. So when I was packing yours, everything went on the rack. And then it gets wrapped. That's how I do everything because that's the only way to keep up with it. If I just lay it on the table and I used to line them up and do them like that, they one would get pushed to the side and then I would pack the order and realizing that 3 days later, there's one between the cracks. So I have a rack where I put all the decants in while I'm packing them. It's a system. And it works pretty good. It's cut down on a lot of mistakes. Somebody got that damn shit. Somebody on and in my book, it says who got it. Look it up. All right, Coke Zero is the first one. I don't know what the hell they expect with this. I do like Coca-Cola. I do like Coca-Cola style fragrances. Let's find out. It smells amazing. It smells a little like, it might be a clone of Mancera's Tonka Cola, as I'm guessing. That's what it reminds me of. It might be a clone of that, but it doesn't say in the description. It smells cinnamon. I smell Coca-Cola, cinnamon, amber. It's fucking beautiful. This, if it's not a clone of Tonka Cola, I'm guessing that's what it is. Because now that I think about it, that's what I feel like this is. But it doesn't say it in the description. I love it. Absolutely love this one. This is way better than that shit that Paris Corner put out. If that's what it is. If you've ever not seen one of these, just so they come in. They got a cool little box. Me, the boxes don't mean anything. I don't have room for them. But that's how they would look. Alexander, they make good products. All right, Funny Bunny. Here we go. And I'm not talking about K. First, let's see what kind of samples they sent me. Samples. Let's see what we got here. All right. We have Black Tie Affair, which I never owned their version of Tuxedo. I actually don't own it. Never have. Smells like Tuxedo. Tuxedo's starting to wane for me. Like, it's no longer one of my favorites, I don't think. Africano is. I love Africano. This is their version of, I think it's Byredo. No, it's not Byredo. Oh, that's nice. I think that is Byredo's Bad Africrete. That's what that is. That is nice. I have a bottle of that. Africano is a really nice fragrance. I gotta buy that Byredo, man. I think it's built for the summer, the winter, anytime. What's going on, Hez? Terry Smiles is in the house. Montrese is in the house. All the family here today, baby. If you're just joining, I just went over Coke Zero. I believe, if any of you guys do know for sure, and Smelly Man, I'll check, okay? But I want you to dig inside that package and let me know. Because I know for one, I'm going to email the person I thought I might have sent it to. And I'll get that person to send it to you. Those are very expensive to redo. I don't want to redo them. At the price I sold them at, I don't want to redo them. So we have to kind of see if we can get them returned to where they need to go. And gladly, I'm not really worried about that. Let's move on. That'll be solved. Okay. Terry Smiles. What's going on, Hernandez? Great to see you. Quick question. Hawaii Ice, when I can find it, dude. It's expensive. I'm not paying over $40 for it. I have a bottle of the other one, Zanzibar, in my cart. Maybe next week it'll be here. I'll have it back in stock. But as far as now goes, there is no more Hawaii Razazi Ice. And I'm not overpaying for it. Maybe I can get a bottle for Fragrance by Canon again. I'll kind of search for it. But I refuse to pay more than what I would pay for it normally. I think it was 50, if I was correct. And I've seen them on eBay for 70 or 80. I'm not paying that. Then I got to turn around and charge y'all more for it. And I don't want to do that either. So, I'll have to find it. Those are two things that have been the hottest things that just sold out. I had 15 samples of each, and they all sold out. Middle Eastern fragrances, man, make me money. Now, I'm not trying to say I'm killing it, but think about it. If it costs me $50 for a bottle and I sell 15 samples at $5, I'm at least making a $25 to $30 to $40 profit. Some of the Middle Easterns are like $25. So I'm making $50 profit off these bottles, which is not bad for a fragrance that I only have $30-$40 invested in. So yeah, Middle Eastern fragrances make me good money. And who was the one that brought that up to me? Can't give myself credit on that one. Great to see Hez Parfums here. Hez, I wore Blue Dog 2 days ago. Gotta wear Blue Dog once a week, baby. It's my signature scent. But check everything again. Because I know there were 3 mLs is what they were. And I remember putting them in there. Somebody got them. We got to find out where they are. I put a tracker on them, too, so we'll find them. Okay, here we go. Funny Bunny. This was an Easter release. I kind of started to catch up on Alexandria releasing these things on holidays, and I always miss on them. But I got this one this time, and now it's sold out. You can't get it. Funny Bunny. I really don't know what the fuck that means. How am I going to tell somebody I'm wearing Funny Bunny? You know, what are you wearing? Funny Bunny. Yeah. What you call me? All right, here we go. Funny Bunny. I don't know what the fuck to think about that shit. Ugh. I don't like it. No. No. That's not funny at all. That doesn't even smell like Easter. It smells like just really bad mix of something. I don't know. It just don't work. I don't want to smell like this. I don't even want nobody ever to try this. No, I know I was harsh on the one duo one. It ended up being pretty good, but this, it maybe ain't ready. This needs to go back in the oven for a couple of days or months. Funny Bunny's disappointment. Coke Zero is nice. So that's a hunt for me. And I don't have a lot of hunts from Alexandria because I'm really picky on what I buy. April 15th, there you go. That's right. It is on the website. That's right. They do put certain restock stuff on there. Frankly, I haven't bought anything from Fragrance by Canada the last couple of weeks, or last week and a half. Usually I buy something. Okay. This took $200 of my money. I always buy the City Rhythms because I have no problem selling out my bottle. I mean, I sell the whole bottle and buy another one. City Rhythm is an easy sell for me because they're super expensive and their samples are small and I sell bigger samples. This one is going to be called Barcelona. If you're familiar with the City Rhythm kind of vibes, it's, you know, different cities and stuff like that. I heard that he had a falling out with his business partner. I don't know and I don't care. But he always puts a little extra thing in there. You know, one time I got a whip. One time I got a keychain, I got a necklace one time. I don't wear nothing. I haven't even tried the whip out yet, to tell you the truth. Shout out to the 30 people watching. I appreciate it. Did you see when I see 30 people, I don't freak out like it's something really unusual, right? You ever seen that? I see some streams when they freak out when they get 30 people. Like, oh my God, 30 people watching. You know, I piss out 30 people. No offense to most folks. I'm just saying. It's a great fragrance, right? It's a good one, I'm telling you. Yeah, Pukey Bunny, you're right. Must be nice. Oh, yeah, and I shot a video for Making Sense last night. Speaking of Making Sense, there he is. You can't. There's nothing that compares to it. I'm just totally honest with you. That's why it's my signature scent. There's nothing close to it. It's like if you put a blueberry sweet hint on Bleu de Chanel, maybe a little bit, but not that much. Great to see Mike here. What's going on? Driving home. I know. Time to go home for the second job. They got third job now, too. All right. So this is Barcelona. Here is the little thing I got. I don't have a lot of hopes for this one. Here's the notes. Okay. We have sparkling wine. We have some kind of orange, pomegranate, cherry in the middle with red wine, rose. This shit's all over the place, man. Musk. I don't know. This one's kind of scares me. Okay. Niles, I love you. This one scares me. All right, so there's my box. I got a little discount because I have a small discount with Niles. He don't can't do much. But I don't mind it at all. This is a cool box. They always come in. Oh, I did get a little necklace. Man, I could think of a necklace. It's a little wine bottle. So it's always some kind of thing. And I add them all together. I treat them like charms. My City Rhythm charms. But there's the box. Then you got the flap that opens up. Some famous YouTuber could learn about presentation a little bit. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying. Well, let's pull it out of this beautiful pillow here. All right, here we go. Here's the bottle. Does it got any kind of sparkle in it? No sparkle. I think he's growing up on us. There is Barcelona. All right, this is going right on my skin. Catch up on the comments. Yeah, that's amazing stuff. That's better than any milk fragrance the dude puts out. Love that stuff. It does have everything but the kiss in it, don't it? That's what it is. You got it right. What's up, Stan? Yeah. Incredible. All right, here we go. I'm ready. I like the label's like a metallic label on there. So, all right, here we go. Where can I go with this one? You're right here in my hand. Good sprayer. Super, super wine, man. There's a lot of wine in this fucking fragrance. You could drink this fucking bottle. I'm telling you that right now. You could smell the red wine. Ooh, a lot of wine in this one. But, ooh, it's not. It catches you off guard how much of that red wine you pick up on. Man, this has got a beautiful opening. Wow. I don't know what to make of it because I feel like I know what to make of it. And I won't get to wear this for like a week. There's no point in me wearing it until I can get close to doing a review on it because I just now caught up with some reviews. Oh, man. I get a little mandarin. I definitely get a lot of wine, but it's not overpowering. It's just right. This is probably the most unique one of the bunch. It's up. It's fresh. It's crisp. I like it. It's weird. It's one is weird. And I was scared of it. I think I like this better than Austin. And I think this is probably my favorite since San Diego. This first impressions go. I can see me wearing this, man. This is legit. This is something different, too. This is a niche fragrance, you know? It has a lot of stuff going on. The next time I do some live, brother, it's coming. It's coming. I just haven't had a chance to really work it out yet. Red wine makes me, but I still haven't forgot. I have a list of people who I want to do a stream with, and you're one of them. I also want to do a couple other people. It's just been a little bit busy. Work is very, very demanding right now. My job, a lot of demand on me, more than normal. Yeah, Niles killed this one. This is a great fragrance. I know he watches these later. Niles did an amazing job. I think it's a hit. I still got dirt on my hand from the damn tire, from changing the tire. Yeah, I think it's a hit. It has this night. I'm gonna spray it in the air one more time. I just want to kind of get a little vibe on the air. Man, that wine is jumping. It's fucking full of wine. Let me read the notes again. Let me take off my glasses. It's got chocolate in the bottom, amber, sandalwood, cedar. It's got sparkling wine, and you do smell the sparkling wine. It's a little more fizzy, a little more bubbly. The orange and the pomegranate, you definitely pick up on the pomegranate because that's the sweet part of this fragrance. And the red wine, the cherry, it just works. Wow. This is a, I would say, boozy, sweet, fresh fragrance, man. And I know it sounds kind of weird to call it that, but even the juice looks like a glass of wine, don't it? You know? It's a beautiful bottle. I like that he's going to other cities now. Maybe we can get one from San Juan. Come on now. Where the fuck's the San Juan fragrance? Shit. Right? Yeah, Niles is really good, and he's passionate. I've had Niles on my channel, and fantastic guy. And I was very young in my journey. I didn't know what the hell I was asking, but now that I've, you know, I have bought every single one of Niles' fragrances, every one of them, and I have supported him thoroughly, and he's been very good to me. But I gotta say, this one might be the most unique. And I did say it's a lot about Nashville, and not Nashville so much. Nashville to me felt like Austin, but New Orleans was definitely more boozy, and it definitely felt like something different. This one's just it's European, man. I don't want to say, I don't know. It just fucking smells great. And I think it will even get better over a little bit of time. Yeah. I'll have samples up for this ready to go here as soon as I get off the stream. I'll put up samples of it. I probably will sell about 80% of the bottle. I got to get Ross Barrett in too. Yeah. I've already had it. I've had, who's Ross Barrett? I don't know who Ross, you mean Ross Barrett? I'm confused. Where's the Detroit fragrance? Well, that's just going to smell like shit and piss. I mean, I don't know what to tell you. I mean, shout out to Detroit, right? Here, listen. No, I'm not going to say it because people live in Detroit. Still. People still live in Detroit? Do they? Real people live in Detroit still? No, not real people. I can imagine living in Detroit. That'd be tough. Barrett fragrances. Oh, okay. I bought Barrett fragrances. I've done videos on them. I'm confused. You mean Ross, who owns Barrett fragrances? Okay. Ah. Man, okay. Okay. Now you got it. Now I'm with you. Now I'm with you. I sorry. My English not too good. I'm sorry. I only get excited when I hear certain things. That's the time I only get excited. Anyways, that's it. It's going to be a quick little video. I just wanted to go over these three new fragrances. I love it. I love it. It's different. It's unique. I would never would have liked this fragrance 5 years ago. I know I say that a lot, but that's part of the fragrance journey. That's part of changing up and growing up. That's part of appreciating other things. And that's part of paying for everything so I can give you my full review and chill free thoughts on things. I don't feel any pressure to like it. I wasn't sure about this one, but I like the direction with this one. We keep making the same stuff over and over again, which I kind of felt we got with Austin and Nashville. This is stepping out a little bit more. Oh, I don't like fragrances that much. What's up, Mike? Great to see you, man. Hell yeah. Listen, I ain't gonna lie. I get emails from people too. I don't even read them. Somebody emailed me about sponsoring some kind of light, like lights, you know, like fluorescent lighting. I'm like, man, I don't want to sponsor shit. But not in that same thing, but the emails I get sometimes, the ones that I want, the people that are trying to reach out to me, I kind of missed out on some emails. So I'm getting a business number set up for certain people. If they want to call me, they can call me. But if you call that number, I know it's business and it's nothing to do with my personal number. And it'll be on the same phone. I can have two numbers on one phone. So yeah. For a good price too. It's like $7 for me to have a second number on my phone. Great to see you, Mike. I curved. What do you mean you curved Dossier months ago? What do you mean? I'm confused. Listen, they stopped. Listen, Dossier messed with me for 2 seconds. When I reached out to them, and they reached out to me, and they were like, blah, blah, blah. You know, the same spiel that auto email they send everybody. And I was like, I can't do it, but if you want to sell me, I'll buy all your fragrances if you give me a discount. Well, they're already discounting. Well, discount them a little bit more. I'm still going to buy them anyways. If you don't discount them again, I'll take your, that's fine. Well, they kept hugging me. We want to send you this. We want, I was like, no, I want to buy it. And I finally said, F you, Dossier, I'm not buying nothing. And that's the reason I don't have any Dossier fragrances. Because they kept nagging me about it. And I know, must be nuts. I know. I'm fucking being stupid here. Must be nuts to be able to turn down free shit. Must be nuts. I get it. But I'm not, that's not me. I ain't the one, baby. I ain't the one. It's a fuck. It's just a shill show. It's all it is. The same shill and that stupid shit out. I don't care how much money people get paid on it. I don't give a shit. Don't care how much money people make off shilling off fragrances. I don't really care. I just don't care. And they're not sharing it with me. And they're not sharing original opinions with me or original thoughts. So I find it kind of fucking useless, to tell you the truth. Come on, that was a good time. That's my boy right there. It's the revolution right there. I smell. I want to put your, you don't want, you know, you don't want it. I'm telling you. Being a sponsor to something means you're a slave to something. And I'm not going to be a slave to anything but me. And that's it. To this room, to these orders, baby. That's it. All clone houses are the same. It's what they bring to the table with their blends and their hybrids and their imagination. That's why Dew is light years ahead of most of them. I'm not saying they're the best customer service or they make the best fragrances, but they have the best marketing, and that's for damn sure. And it ain't even close. Yeah, think about it, man. By this way, the fragrance is really, it's even getting better. Now I'm getting more cherry. It's like a nice cherry wine. It's beautiful. The wine is hanging around. I'm getting fucking drunk over here. I lick my hand. I'm not going to be able to drive after this shit. Like that blue Jew one. I've turned down some other stuff too. It's just, you know, did you get it in or have they shipped it yet? That's my question. And did you order it on Christmas and it just now arrived? What's up, Darren Dre? Good to see you, man. Kaylin, what's going on, baby? Send a date, shit's bond, the great one. Yeah, I would never buy anything ever again from Jumbo Shop unless they would deliver it in a week. And I doubt they can do that. So anyways, this was going to be a quick video. I got to go. I hate to leave 36 people hanging. I'm sorry. But I want to, it's 9:30. I plan to go to bed early tonight, like in an hour. Been very sleepy the last couple days. I have 2 orders to pack. That's it. Don't have content to make. I made it all already. Damn. You're the lucky one, then. You're the lucky one. Not everybody else gets that lucky. I guess they got to have once in a while, they got to ship one out fast. So you can come on here and tell us how fast it ships. And then we'll give them a second chance. And then when we get our order, it takes 6 months. their deals aren't that good. I mean, that's just me. I'm a Jama Shah hater, so that's just me. I don't think their deals are that good. I don't like the way the website's set up. I don't like anything about it. Maybe it's just me. And I don't fault anybody for buying on there. But Jama Shop, this, not you guys, but like all the simping that goes on for Jama Shop. I don't get it. I get it why they do it. They have no souls. They don't care. They'll sell their mother for $2. And it's never a big deal. Fragrance by Canada, Vemba. Believe me, how long have I been doing this, guys? A long time. I know where to get the best deals at when it comes to making samples. I know I'm going to pay full retail sometimes. Don't mind it at all. Except for that Roja. I'm going to end up losing money on that Roja. That's for fucking sure. I did a review on it. I realized, I haven't sold but three samples of this. This motherfucker's going to cost me money. By the time I sell the bottle, it's going to be, you can get one for $250. So, yeah, because there's no way that Isola store is going to stay up there like Isola Blue. It will drop a lot faster in price. Jomo Shop. They should call it Jomo Shop because it's slow as hell. Well, who makes the vanilla oud, by the way? I like it. I need to watch that review, Kingdom. I do like that fragrance. I mean, I do like the note sound of that one. So, that's it. We will have a dual haul hopefully this weekend or Monday. It hasn't even shipped yet. I'm hoping I'll get a shipping notification tomorrow and it'll be overnight and I can get it Friday, maybe. If not, it'll be Monday. Virtus. Okay. Okay, got it. But I want to say thank you for the people watching tonight. This was a quick video. I need to get to work. I'm going to go to bed early tonight. I want to go out there and make sure that my donut is still got air in it. So I'm about to get up early tomorrow morning because I got to take my son. He's sick. So he's not feeling well. So he's going to go stay with his grandmother. So I have to take him there. So I want to get enough sleep tonight because I felt very, very tired all day this week. And it's because I was averaging 4 to 5 hours of sleep every night, doing content, packing orders. And tonight I had very little to do. So it's off the bed early for me like an old man. What's my favorite Alexandria? Still probably Work Hard, Stay Humble or Executive Order. Those are my favorites, right? Still to this day. Listen, I'm still fighting these people over this damn Privé I bought that's fake. She's like, leave it on the porch. I'm like, bitch, that don't work. I can't leave it on the porch. Ain't nobody picking this shit up. And I keep leaving it on the porch, and my dog keeps trying to eat it. And they're like, I said, can you not just send me a return label? I'll fucking pay for the return label. I want my fucking $150 back. So I'm like, fighting with it. I guess they keep going till you give up. But I'm not going to give up. I'm about to go argue with the city about this pothole that cost me a tire today. It cost me probably $60. I mean, it's not like it's a small company. It's a big conglomerate. And they're fighting me over sending me a fucking label. Just send me a label. And I don't want to hear about this on past the return period because this email chain has been going on 2 days after I got it. So I'm going to sit here and fight with them the whole time. I want my $150 back. I should have known better that was a fake. But, you know, I took a chance. You never know, right, until you try. Must be nice to be able to piss out $150. I know, right? I know. Anyways, let's wrap this up. I'm out of here. Y'all have a good night. Thank you so much for tuning in. Remember what I always tell you, if you smell good, you feel good, it's going to be all good, but also don't let the haters tell you what to do. Tell them what to do, baby. I'm going to go out with a little bit of the Youngbloods, but I'm going to go out with a Youngblood song that is my absolute favorite Youngblood song. And it is called 85 Billy D Interlude, baby. A little bit of that. I know what you're waiting, baby. I'll be there, shorty. Don't be patient because I'm coming to you. Riding dirty down 85. I know.
You know you ain't cheap for me. Not a wind blows as I'm on it at 5 and she be through it. With 6-pack of that Colt 45, just like I should. And if I could, I will, I might get blown tonight. If things go right, when I gave my shit, ain't ready to still indeed. She on her knees, keeping things steady like Betty Crocker, the face doctor. Just that she swallows with passion. So now she bragging, lagging behind with questions she now be asking. So time is passing, now I'm messing on. I'm gone, living in the world of hope. So I suppose it's going down to be your city, cause in these parts ain't nothing but hard times. And I shouted, please, really. I know you waiting for daddy, you're walking out, stopping to be patient, cause he's coming to get you. Dirty, I'm making time, so they can be easy. I don't want nothing to keep me from you. I know you waiting for daddy, you're walking out, stopping to be patient, cause he's coming to get you. Dirty, I'm making time, so they can be easy. Shit, I'm looking for anything, cut them up like everything in my stage. Sir Lucius, with the neighborhood is ready for the game. Ready for the game. Fuck all that people.
You like an intolerant, then let the whole swallow it. Well, I'm the best there is, plain and simple. I mean, I wake up in the morning, I piss excellent.